Hey guys, Suraj here from the Milk Glass Breaker. In today's video, let's talk about the online exam pattern of Amity Online University and also how the online exams are conducted. So without much further ado, let's get into the video. Guys, before entering into the video, if you are new to my channel or if you're viewing my video for the first time, please go ahead and subscribe and click on the thumbs up button because I'm going to talk more about the examination process during the exam as well. So do not miss out on those videos. Go ahead and click the subscribe button. Now, entering into the topic, the first and most important thing is everybody needs to understand the process of examination, right? Now, in Amity Online, the best part that I personally feel is that it is an online proctored examination. What is the meaning of online proctored examination? You can take the examination at your desired location. You can take it at your place, you can take it at your office, you can take it at your grandmom's place, you could take it at your colleague's place, but you need to have a basic devices or, you know, a criteria in order to fulfill those examinations. And the first thing is you need to have a good laptop or a good CPU. Now, when you talk about a laptop, the basic RAM that you need to have is a 4GB laptop, needs to have an internet connection through an Ethernet cable or through a Wi-Fi, and you need to have a good webcam. All these three are the most important things. Please note, most of the people will have a good working CPU or a laptop, but the webcam might not be clear, it might be flickering, it might be blurry. Your examination, the proctor who's sitting on the other end will not allow you to take the examination. In case your system is all good, you have the internet connection, but your webcam is not good, please opt for another laptop or go for a secondary webcam that you find it on Amazon. For example, Logitech has a separate webcam that you can connect it with your laptop using a USB connector. Go ahead and buy a secondary webcam. Webcam is very important, guys. Don't take it light. It shouldn't be flickering. It should not be blurred. And the fourth criteria in order to take an online proctored examination is the room should be well lit. For example, take the place that I'm sitting at. You can see me clearly. You can see my shoulders. You can see what's happening in my background. And this pin drop of silence, this is exactly how it needs to be during your examination. You need to sit in a location that's well lit. People should be able to see your face clearly. Your shoulders should be seen in the camera because, you know, the other proctored might think that you're doing some malpractice during your examination process, which again, you'll be paused during the examination. In order to avoid all those problems, please make sure your webcam is set up where your shoulders are seen, your face is seen clearly, the location or the surrounding should be well lit, nobody should be walking in the background, and there should be no noise. Technically, please stay in a quiet environment, probably shut off your doors, shut off your windows, and make sure that only you are there in your room. These are the basic criteria in order to take the examination. The second thing is, once you log into your LMS, you will have go to examination in your LMS. Once you go through that, there will be a step-by-step guide. If you know how to read English, it is as simple as that. Nothing to worry about it. Everything is being put down there. And during your hall ticket, you know, a process where you enroll into your admit card, you will also have like a demo of how to get into the examination and things like that. There itself, you'll understand how to log in, how to share your screen and everything. The most important criteria is you can have a secondary keyboard and a mouse connected, but you cannot have a secondary monitor or a projector connected because that will not allow. The software which you're entering into will check all of those criteria. If you're connected to a secondary monitor or projector, it is not going to let you in. So please make sure that you disconnect, because there'll be a lot of working professions who might use a secondary monitor for their Excel or, you know, Google Meet and things like that. Please disconnect all of those secondary monitors or projectors and you should be good enough in order to take the examination. Now, this is the examination process. If you have any more doubts or if I've missed any points on the examination process, please put it down in the comment section. I'll try making another video, or if it's a simple one, I'll try and explain in the comments itself. Now, the most important thing is for a student who's entering into the exam is, how is the exam pattern? How are the questions asked and what are the marks and how everything needs to be done? The first thing is, you should have completed your internal assignments and assessments, which is there in your LMS. If in case you're already a student of Amity Online, you'll know how it works. The moment you log into your LMS, you'll have various subjects. Into each subject, there are various videos. After every module, there's something called module assignment. So there are 5 modules in every subject. You need to complete all the 5 internal assignments, and there is a assignment 2, which is an overall assignment for that particular subject. So you need to first finish all the 5 module assignments, then an overall assignment. So totally you will have 6 assignments per subject. You need to finish all of that. And once you, probably if you have 5 subjects in a SEM, you need to finish all the 5 subjects internal assignments and the second assignment, which is an overall assignment. Okay, this is the first criteria for you to enter into your examination. So you get 30 marks from here itself. Probably if you excel in all of these things, you get full 30 marks. The minimum passing mark should be 15 in each subject is what I believe. No, it's not 15, it's 12, I believe. I'll probably make sure of this. Ask me in the comment section and I'll type if whether it's 12 or it's 15. I'm assuming it's 12 and not 15. But it's better if you score above 20. I'll tell you why, because it's an open book, guys. There's no proctoring for internal assignments or anything like that. Just Google and get your answers done. It should be an easy 30 mark scoring, guys. So please make sure that you get good marks. Do not delay till the end and don't lose out on marks, because it's very easy to get these 30 marks. Then once you're into your examination, there are 3 different steps in your end term examination. There'll be section A, section B and section C. So I'll talk about first C, because C is very easy. It's MCQ, multiple option questions. You'll get close to 20 questions. Each question will contain 2 marks. 20 MCQs, each question will contain 2 marks. Now this is as simple, because you just have a question and you have 4 options. You just need to select these options and you'll get full marks then and there. And since it's 2 marks per question, 20 into 2 is 40 marks, guys. You get 40 marks in MCQs itself. So it's as easy as scoring 40 marks. Please prepare all of the live classes. Please prepare the MCQs that are there at the end of every module. Please go through your study materials. Please attend all the live lectures that are happening and all the videos that are there in your LMS, and it should be as simple as that for you to get these 40 marks. Now coming to section A, you'll have 4 questions, out of which you'll have to attend only 2 questions. You can attend any 2, doesn't have to be 1 or 2 or 3 or 4. You can even jumble and attend 1 and 4 or 3 and 2. You can attend however you want, but you need to attend only 2 questions out of 4. Now each question is a descriptive. You might have to type it. You can't write it in a paper and then submit it as a PDF. Doesn't work that way. You'll have to type it using your keyboard. Now these are descriptive questions, and it's each question contains about 7.5 marks. Okay, so most of the people will have a doubt of what should be the character count. If it's a 7.5, I'm sure it should be above 400 words, right? You can't write it in 150, or it can't be a one-line answer. So make sure that you have good amount of content. Usually my suggestion would be have beyond 300 words. If it's about 300 words, then you're good to go. But don't have it less than 300 words, because that becomes too small for 7.5 marks. So that's how you answer your section A. Now section B is a case study where they will give you a sort of a description. You might have to go through it and attend your answer for the question that they've asked at the end of that description. Now again, there are only 2 questions in section B, and you have to attend both the questions. Now if I have to club all the marks, section A you have 4 questions, out of which you have to attend only 2, which each question is 7.5, so you'll get 15 marks at the end of 2 questions. Then section B is again you have 2 questions, each question again contains 7.5 marks, so you will again get another 15 marks. So 15 plus 15 is 30. So section A and B you'll get 30 marks, and section C, which is MCQ, you'll have 20 questions, each question is 2 marks, so there'll be 40 marks. So it's 30 plus 40, 70 marks. Then again, you have another 30 in your internal assignments, which is of 30 marks, so total of 100 marks. This is as simple as your examination is. If you go through if you go through all the materials and LMS, your videos and everything, It's easy, guys. Don't worry. Don't break your head. It's after all an examination. The most important thing is please attend all the examination if you're a first semester or second semester student. No matter what work you have, please try attending, because if you are, you know, finishing all of your MCQs and if you're passing it, you're as good as passing the subject with a good amount, at least a second level marks. Please don't skip it, because as you skip it and if you go to the next semester, you're just piling up with a lot of examination, because in a semester you have 5 subjects. If you're not attending all the 5 subjects for the next semester, you have 5 plus 5, and if you're not attending 4 subjects out of that for the next semester, you have 5 plus 4 plus 5, and that is gonna put a lot of pressure on you, where a lot of people even quit doing the degree itself. So do not do that. Even if you're prepared or not prepared, even if you're vaguely prepared for the examination, give it a try. You do not know what's gonna happen, right? Give it a try. Maybe the questions will be easy because you went through all the live lectures. It'll be as easy because you understood the topic, so you're gonna type it in your own words, and you might even pass the examination. You don't know. So please attend the examination. That's the most important thing. With that, I think I've covered the process of examination and the pattern of examination. If you guys have more doubts regarding this, put it out in the comment section. I'll be good enough to answer your comments whenever I'm free. And if you haven't still subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and subscribe. Give me a thumbs up. Peace. I will meet you in the next video. Till then, Suraj here, signing off from TMCB. Peace.